In this video, we cover the IP address requirements for a DP4400 appliance. To ensure that your DP4400 appliance performs effectively in your environment, you need some information about the network in which the appliance will operate. This information includes the IP addresses for various appliance components and network-related details. The network details include the subnet mask, default gateway, and the DNS server IP addresses for identifying the appliance components on the network. Furthermore, the domain name, the NTP, SMTP, and SNMP server IP addresses are also required. Finally, the IP address of the Dell EMC Support Remote Services Gateway Server is also required. Configure the SRS Gateway Server to proactively engage support and minimize downtime. Before getting into the IP address assignment details, it's important to ensure that these IP addresses are added to the DNS server's forward and reverse lookup zones. Also, it's important to verify that these IP addresses are not in use in your network and are resolvable using commands like ping and NSLookup. Use the network validation tool, commonly known as NVT, to check if the IP requirements are met. It checks for the availability of the unused IP addresses for the appliance components and looks up these IP addresses in the DNS server for host names. It also validates other network information such as domain name, NTP, SNMP, and SMTP servers. You can download the NVT from the link provided in the video description. Then install and run the NVT on the system connected to the network on which you plan to deploy the appliance. Let's take a look at the assignment of the 13 unused IP addresses. Of the 13 unused IP addresses, one IP address is assigned to the Appliance Configuration Manager, another is assigned to the ESXi server, and finally, the remaining 11 IP addresses are assigned to the appliance components. Ensure that the 11 IP addresses in a range are from the same subnet. Use this table to learn how the 11 IP addresses are assigned to different appliance components. One IP address is assigned to the cluster manager, one for the protection storage management connection, and a couple for the protection storage backup connections, one for the backup server, and one for the backup proxy server, one for the system manager, and a couple for the reporting and analytics component. And finally, one each for the search and cloud disaster recovery components. Note that the reporting and analytics, search, and cloud disaster recovery components are optional. And if you choose not to install these, the required IP address count is reduced. For more information on prerequisites, visit the DP4400 support page.